Hey guys, so I'm gonna be teaching a Broadway jazz heels combo to Cell Block Tango from the musical Chicago. I love Chicago. I love just the feel of it, the look of it, everything. Dream role, Velma Kelly. Hit me up, anyone doing that production. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it and have fun. Okay, so let's get started. This is in the first verse, and this is pop, like the pop verse. So we start out foot beveled. I like to do that a lot, I've noticed. We start out foot beveled, and you're gonna reach up your right arm, and your chin is down, and you're gonna roll your head. And the key with that is to not get off balance. So you gotta really tighten your abs or whatever is there and roll your head. And then you're gonna do, cross your right arm over your head and do like a step out with your right foot and do a hip roll. So the words are, you know how people have these little habits that get you down? Like Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum. No, not chew, pop. So again, what you're gonna do there is you're out here, you're gonna bring it in, and you're gonna go down. And so it's like, it's kind of like you're in parallel, and you're gonna do like forced arch and squat, but instead of leaving your knees in parallel, you're gonna turn out your feet and legs when you get to the bottom. And then you're gonna come up for a second, and then you're gonna slap forward. Yeah? So, one more time. That is, you know how people have these little habits that get you down? Like Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum. No, not chew, pop. All right, let's move on. So you're gonna lean towards your left side. And I think what helps to do this is like bring your knees together a little bit, but the left one comes to the right one and sit on your booty. And then you're gonna fan to the back and plant back again to the front. So the words for that are, so why come home this one night? And you should be planted on night. And then when you're here, she says, and I was really irritated. And so you're gonna flip your head twice, really irritated, like very forcefully. So again, you're here, pop. So I come home this one night and I was really irritated. And then you're gonna slide onto the floor and your body becomes straight. Your left arm is planted in front of you and your right arm is laying down. I hope you can see this. If not, do your best to follow along. So you slide down on looking for a little sympathy. And on there's Bernie, you're gonna roll and face the ceiling and your arm comes across your chest on the, and that's on there's Bernie. And on sitting on the couch and drinking a beer, you're gonna roll up and your chest leads that and your hands can kind of help support you. So sitting on the couch, drinking a beer and chewing. And on chewing, your right foot is gonna come, make sure your feet are pointed down here. Flex feet do not look pretty. Pointed, even in heels if you're wearing them. And on chewing, you're gonna look at the audience and bring your right foot up like almost in passe. Okay? And chewing. And then on no, not chewing, you're gonna reach down and kind of like caress the length of your leg. So it's no, not chewing, popping. And on popping, you're just gonna whack that right leg wherever you want it to whack, and you're gonna look back at the audience. So no, not chewing, popping. And so then once you're done with your, this is an unflattering position, once you're done with your popping, you're gonna cross your right foot over your left foot and use that to help you stand up. Okay, so let's do it from the beginning. Let's do it from the beginning. So we have, you know how people have these little habits that get you down? Like Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum. No, not chew, pop. So I come home this one night and I was really irritated and looking for a little sympathy. And there's Bernie lying on the couch, drinking a beer and chewing. No, not chewing, popping. So I said to him, but let's move on. Okay, so you stand up on, so I said to him, I said, and you're just gonna do, it's not even really a turn, but if you wanted to call it a turn, be like a coupe turn. So your left foot comes into coupe behind your leg. And so I said to him, I said, Bernie, and this is, you're leaning into your right hip. That leg is bent. Your left foot isn't just beveled, but you're actually like not even putting any weight on that toe. So you could lift it and do whatever you want with it. So you're here. So I said to him, I said, Bernie. And your arms just kind of caress out. Bernie. And you're just gonna kind of command the stage here. You pop that gum one more time. And you can walk wherever you want. You can walk forward, you walk to the side, you can walk around your refrigerator if you're doing this in your kitchen, wherever you'd like to walk. And on one more time, your arms are just gonna go one more time. And then you're gonna strike a pose, whatever you want it to be. But it has to be something that leaves your right foot free. So I recommend that good old bevel the right foot, and you're gonna laugh. So the next words are, she stands up, I said to him, I said, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. And you can do whatever you want with your arms, like, and he did, whatever you wanna do. I'm gonna go, and he did. What you're gonna do next is your right foot's gonna shoot out, yeah? So, bah! And your arms are gonna shoot out also, okay? So I took the shotgun, and what that is a for sure coupe turn in forced arch on your main, on your standing leg. So all that means is your leg is bent and you're in releve. And coupe means it's like in the lower half of your calf, turned out. Yeah, okay. So you shoot out. What your legs are gonna do is a coupe turn over your right shoulder, so an outside turn, and your arms kind of help with that momentum by scooping around your head like this. Yeah? So I took the shotgun, you're gonna end up kind of facing this corner and you're gonna put your weight onto that foot and do like a very low arabesque turn. and then here, and you're gonna, it's only gonna be a half turn because you're gonna land facing the back, and then you're gonna do another half turn here. Yeah, actually, I think it's like one and a half. Here's what it looks like all together. Play with it how you will. So you just did, and he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired. Yeah? So let's break that down. So you're here, you're here, you're here, you're here, and whoop, and plant. Kind of hard to do slow, but once again, you stick that foot out, coupe turn on dehors, arabesque turn, plant here, en dehors, turn, and plant down. Yeah? So, like, the momentum of where you're going stays the same. You're turning en dehors, you're turning clockwise, but your feet keep changing. So, if you just want to do, like, a little mini turn because you don't want to confuse yourself, that's totally fine, too. You just end up here. So, you're here, you just did this turn down. You're gonna do a rond de jambe back, and both of your feet should be turned out. Your hips should be square, and your arms kind of like do whatever you want that goes with the flow. I kind of bend my left arm a little bit, straighten my right to kind of match what the rond de jambe looks like with my legs. So, I'm here. You're going to swoop and plant, and then you're gonna go into his head and come back here. So let's do it from Bernie. So I said to him, I said, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots into his head. Yeah? Let's do it with music. Okay, let's keep going. We're almost there. So we just did into his head. Bah! He had it coming. He had it coming. He only. So the footwork in the bottom half of your body is just doing step, touch, step, touch, step, touch, step, touch. Your arms are going reach, 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 head. Yeah, so that's right, left, back, head. So together, he had it coming, right, left, back, head. Okay, keep moving. You're going to step with your right foot, catch under yourself and flick. So it looks like that. So you're here on the last head, you're going to step, catch, flick. Yeah? Feel free to rewind that slow-mo so you get what that looks like. And your arms are going duh. From here, cross, at. So, you just did duh, duh, flick. You're going to step onto that right foot and swivel your upper body So it's here and your left foot is out in kind of a semi-bent winged position. So again, from the chorus. His head. But he had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to. Okay, you're gonna turn now over your left shoulder and your right foot becomes your standing leg in the turn. And this is a turned in coupe turn here. Yeah? So you're here, you turn, and you actually land the turn with your arms. It's like their back, it's very Fosse-esque. Their back and your palms are facing up, and it's almost like you're about to like grab something, but they're back here. So you're here, you turn, and land. Okay? You land here, you're gonna go down, and your upper body kind of folds over. That's also very Fosse. So you fold, and then you go up. He had it coming. He had it coming. I had himself to blame. But if you'd have been there, da da da. And so you go down, you go up again. And that's you, the come up again is been there. And then on the drum roll, your leg comes into passe, turned in, and you're still on a bent standing leg. And then you do a little shimmy. And you can make it like this or like however you want to do it. I'm going to do it with these classic arms just so they're consistent, but you can do it however you'd like. So, let's see. We're here. We did step, catch under, step, touch, turn, out, over, up. Whoop. You're gonna then, after the brr, your step, ball, change, fan. Yeah? And if you just wanna do, like, if you're like, oh, I'm not flexible, totally fine. To be honest, I'm not flexible either. So after that ball change, you can make it like a small little fan. You can make it a very like medium, you know, classic performer kind of cabaret performer fan, or you can make it huge windmill fan, whatever you'd like to do. So you just did brrrra, ball change fan. I betcha you're gonna reach. You would have. And the footwork is just reach over with your left foot and you kind of lean into your left hip and back and your arm just points. You would have, you're gonna just turn with your arms in this signature position by your side, done the same. Yeah, so again, that's you would have done the same. Okay, so that is all. Congrats for learning it. Let's try it all with the music. Feel free, of course, at this point, to go back, review all that stuff we just learned, post music run. But thanks so much for watching. I hope you liked it. Yeah, here we go. Thank you.
so you just finished the tutorial for Cell Block Tango. I hope you liked it. It was a lot of fun to make. Let me know if you have ideas for other songs that you'd like to see me choreograph to, and I'll do my best to fit it in. Thanks for watching.